Hello everyone, welcome back to this hands-on session on dictionaries part 2 video. So there are not much programs left here. So just in the previous video, in the theoretical part, I was explaining you how we can actually use dictionaries and files here. So our main intention here was to find the occurrences of a word in a text file. So I have created a text file here, and whatever you know, the text was there in that notes, the same text I have given here. So let us see now how it is giving us the occurrences. So it is prompting for the file name. Word1.txt is the file wherein I have saved. So here, if you look into this, and my word file is it is not having any sort of it doesn't have any punctuations, comma, anything. It is because here our split is happening along the space here, the white space. So here it is giving me all the occurrences according to that file only here, as to what that file has. So here is repeated thrice, the is repeated thrice, whereas East, Juliet, all these are repeated only once here. So this was the occurrences of words within a file, how we have retrieved that and counted it as a part of the dictionary. I told you already. Now how we can use the looping concept through a dictionary. So this is a dictionary called counts. So for key in the counts, I'm just trying to just loop it, and I'm trying to extract and print them. So it is nothing, it's not doing anything great here. It is just extracting those key as well as the value. So here my keys are 1, 2 and 3, and their respective values are 1, 42 and 100. So this is just an example to show that how we can make use of this loops within the dictionary. And next was a problem where if we had a problem wherein we had to count or to find the entries of values within a dictionary which had the value above 10, that is only the value. So here I've taken four such key value pairs here, and I'm trying to find out. So here, according to this example, 31, 343 are above 10. So if I have to find out the values above 100, then I get the output as only PQR and 300 key value pair. So this is nothing much. We are using a for loop and looping across the dictionary called as counts, and we are finding if counts of key. So when I say key, I'm referring to ABC. When I say counts of key, I'm basically referring to the value of ABC 31 or value of XYZ 2. So when you have to refer to the value, you are going to use this format, that is the dictionary of the key. That will basically give you the value. And then I'm just printing only those key and the value pair which have the value greater than 100. So here whatever the question will be based on that, the condition you can specify here. So this was about that one example. And the next example was wherein we had to print the keys in the alphabetical order. So it was not about the value, it was only about the keys, that is the key to be printed in the alphabetical order. Whatever order they might be, we will sort it and we will print it the alphabetical order. So accordingly, my keys here are XYZ, ABC, PQR and STU. So I have I told you in the theory video only, we are creating a list out of the dictionary, and then we are performing the sorting on that list. We are not directly performing or applying our sort on the dictionary here. So when I run this, you can see the output here. It is sorted. ABC is first, PQR, STU and then XYZ. So first our list is printed. So here I have given a print of list. So if you see here in my list, we have extracted only the keys here. The values we have not extracted. The reason is we are not worried about values. We need to sort the keys here. Okay, so this is that program of sorting the keys in alphabetical order. And the last program is to count the occurrences of word in a file. This is a second type. So here, why is this a second type? Is because here our file will be having some punctuations, all these special characters and all. So we'll see how the translation is done. So the word file, let me just change it. Initially it didn't have any punctuations in the type one what we were doing. Now I'll just change it. So let me just change it. I have I have done the changes here. So let me show you what is the text file look like. So I've stored it here in this text file called Word. So if you see here, I have added all these special characters here. And now when we try to execute this, so it is prompting for the file name, which is word1.txt. So even with all the different punctuations, everything, our file is working. The reason is that we have used this translation line.make_trans, and then here what we are doing here is that we have converted, or if there are any spaces even before, that is any spaces even before the beginning of your line, even that we are just removing. Or I told you, even the lower and upper, if there's any mismatch in the cases, even that also we are taking care of here by using our string functions. And here the string dot punctuation is nothing but this is basically it is a file, or it consists of all the punctuation. So that's the reason we are importing string here. If you don't want to do it this way, you can just specify directly which are those punctuations here, or this will consist of all those different punctuations. So whatever those punctuations are there in this delete from the string or remove from the string, I just told you in the previous theory video only. So first two will be your two, and the start from, that is from and the two, which can be empty. And this is nothing but what should be deleted from the file. So that is you are basically ignoring or omitting all those punctuations. So even though our text file has punctuations, we are able to ignore or omit that, delete that, and we are able to find out the occurrences. Even this, so let us just check the case also here. I have changed the case also to uppercase of the word is. Let us check whether this is also working. Word1.txt. So even now, is this showing? Three times only, because although I have changed this IS to capital, because we have used the two lower here. So whatever cases are, we are ignoring, and everything is considered to be a lower case. So even if and also you want to check, just change it to uppercase and, but still it is not considered as a separate word. It is considered as and only, because we have used the two lower function. Okay, so now and is again showing three times only repeated. So in this way, even though in your file maybe you have written two words, like if I have a word Python, one word has P in uppercase, the other may be in lowercase. So this program won't consider that two Pythons to be two different words. Instead, it will take those two as same only. So the count will be taken as two, not as Python with P upper as one and Python with P lower as one won't be considered. And even if there are any punctuations, as in this word text file, what you are seeing, lot of punctuations are there. Even that will also be deleted, and your text file is splitted, even though it is the splitting doesn't happen only across your that is your spaces here. Even the punctuation is also considered. So this was about the dictionaries topic. So with these two videos, with that is hands-on and the explanation, the dictionary concept ends here. The next video I will be sending about tuples. Thank you, everyone.